was watching Schindler's List, and this moment happened that it just stuck with me. It's a scene where all the Jews are being thrown out of Warsaw, and it's very sad. And they're going down the street, and there's these Polish people that aren't Jewish watching them leave.
Right.
And one of them is a little girl, and she's about 7 years old, and she's on a mailbox, and she's very cute, and she's yelling, "Goodbye, Jews!"
This is Louis C.K. on Conan, both non-Jews, talking about a subject which is very, very dangerous to talk about when you're trying to be funny, whether you're Jewish or not.
Goodbye, Jews! And this really left an impression on me, and probably on the Jews that she was yelling at, too.
Louis makes a point in this interview in saying that there's a showreel somewhere in Spielberg's office with little American girls saying, "Goodbye, Jews! Goodbye, Jews! Goodbye, Jews!" And she got the role because she said it with such force and meaning. Now, for a non-Jew to broadcast this is actually a little bit awkward from my perspective. Whereas if it was Mel Brooks, a Jewish comedian of long standing, then, you know, it would have been very funny. Sadly, a lot of those Jewish comics that can get away with this are passing away. Interestingly enough, I found this very same piece this week alongside some other more contemporary film. An example here of history repeating itself.
I have a Jewish mother-in-law. Okay, maybe the bright lights are blending in with the blonde streaks, but I am a black woman with a Jewish mother-in-law, okay? Now, you know the only thing we have in common. We don't want to get our hair wet. Hey.
So he's an African-American comedian who, from all accounts, is telling a joke about her Jewish mother-in-law. It's actually really funny for Jews to tell jokes about their mother-in-laws, but somehow for a non-Jew to do it just doesn't seem to work.
So there was big drama when we got the sonogram results. She was very excited. Okay, so now that we know we're having a little girl, I'd like to know what you plan on naming our little Chachka. Okay? Okay. Now, I realize there's a difference in the background with the African-American colored, whatever you people call yourselves these days. But I don't want a name that's difficult to pronounce, like Shaniqua or Shaquandra.
What I find funny is when Jews are telling you a story, they're actually telling you something which might be amusing, but is also really interesting as well.
I am Joanna Hausman. Hausman, not Salas or Gomez. Hausman. Why? Because I am Latin American and Jewish. Oh. Sometimes when I explain this to people, they say,
"Dude, what you just said makes no sense."
Or,
"I think I'm trashed."
Okay, not the second part, but the first part, like a lot. But I am just one of over 500,000 Latinos with Jewish heritage. Look, here comes one now.
De verdad tengo.
Salud.
Me siento super estúpido en esta camisa.
What a mensch! Vete. Salte. Salte. So how did this special breed come to be? Well, Jews have been making their way to America since 1492, when Christopher Columbus's crew was made of a bunch of Jews.
Yay!
And that rhymed. But the biggest migration of Jews happened after World War II, when people were like,
"Yo, we should get the f*** out of Europe."
And while some Jews went to places like New York, others were like,
"Yeah, I feel like we should just go here."
Now you can find Jewish last names in Venezuela, Colombia, Mexico, therapist couches, Chile, Brazil. In fact, Argentina has
one of the poblaciones más grandes del mundo, boludo.
Fun fact about Argentinian Jews, they are just as cocky as the non-Jews.
Thank you!
And when Jews take to the stage in Jewish comedy, that's even more powerful. This is the latest stage play from America, not that Jewish.
Mom, do I have a Jewish heart? Of course you do, darling. We're Democrats. But if we don't go to temple, are we still Jewish? Sweetie, you don't need to go to a place to be Jewish, especially if the place is hot and if you're late, there's no parking spaces. We're Jewish, sweetheart. Just not very religious.
one minority making fun of another minority is probably not going to be that popular. I'm sure a white man telling a joke about a black man's community really wouldn't go down well at the moment in the States. But in Israel, they have a laugh and a joke at just about everything, including the way in which they tell you to look after yourself and remain secure on an airplane. Alternatively, you can take it to the next level of airplane comedy humor.
Gentlemen, and unfortunately, ladies, welcome on board El Al Flight 613 from JFK to Jerusalem with stops in Bnei Brak and Beit Shemesh. Here at El Al, our first commitment is to safety, your spiritual safety. When the seatbelt sign illuminates, you must fasten your seatbelt by inserting the metal fittings into each other and pulling on the loose end of the strap. Should you discover that you are seated next to a woman, however, kindly lift the upper portion of the buckle, release your seatbelt, and proceed to any of the aircraft's designated male congregation areas. In the unlikely event that the flight attendant insists that you remain in your assigned seat, simply reach under your seat, pull out the full body protection vest, slip it over your head, and adjust the straps as necessary. Use the attached shofar if you need to alert the crew to any danger. You will find this and other relevant safety information in the Megillah located in the seat pocket in front of you. Should all else fail, please remove it and recite the necessary prayers. After all, in the sky, you are very close to God. We wish you a safe and enjoyable flight.